This is a bit of a pathetic rant, really. Just need to share a bit about my health. I don't need to share it, but I want to share it. Because I think there's something very interesting about what happens when your body gets out of kilter and how it reacts and how sometimes the cure can be worse than the disease. I bet you've never seen a werewolf with glasses before. I don't want you to see my face because it's a mess, as is any of the skin, my skin, which has been in the sunlight. As some of you will know, I was forced really into, I know no one forced me, but I felt I had to take an antibiotic for a fairly extended period of time. I don't like antibiotics, but just sometimes you have no choice, do you? You need to do something to prevent or to stop what's happening. And the infections that I had in my sinuses and my ear were making life impossible, so I had to. Unfortunately, the medication that I was given, it seems I have an allergy to, but not an allergy that manifested itself very clearly. It's a particular antibiotic that can have an effect on your skin, and I'd seen that, you know, you read it, but I honestly didn't realise it could have be so bad. I've had an allergic reaction to it, basically. So 5 weeks after I've stopped taking the antibiotics, I went, you'd think, wouldn't you, that it would be out of your system by then. I went out in the warm, not hot, far from hot, April sunshine for a walk, and didn't think about it, didn't think there would be any problem until every area of my skin that the sun had been exposed to had a major meltdown, and it looks like I've aged about 10 years on my face, and my hands and lower arms where it was exposed are all wrinkled and raw. And it's just really distressing. And I went to the doctor, who's a lovely guy. I mean, it wasn't his fault. He wasn't to know I was going to have this kind of a reaction. And, you know, I've got a shed load of stuff to put on it and to take because it's an allergic reaction. But he said that, because I said, this is not like normal sunburn, because it isn't. It's completely different. I mean, I've got quite olive skin anyway and don't normally react to the sun at all. Even at a very hot sun, I will just go brown. But my skin's red and blotchy and dry and sore and itchy and stinging. And anything I put on it was just making it worse. And he said that basically I'm allergic to the sun at the moment, and that it's not, I'm not reacting it to it for the because of the heat. I'm reacting to it as if I'm having a chemical put on my skin every time I'm exposed to it. So we've got to find a factor 50 sunscreen that I'm not allergic to, because I seem to be allergic to everything at the moment. So I've been putting a baby hyperallergenic sunscreen on my skin, which I'm allergic to. So my holiday, when I eventually go, is going to be fab. I'm going to, first time in years I've gone somewhere hot. I'm not going to be able to sit out in it. And it's making me feel really groggy and shit, to be honest. I feel tired and lethargic all the time. And as you know, I'm not particularly prone to feeling sorry for myself. And I'm not after your pity. I just feel the need to share it out there. That it feels very odd because I feel like because, you know, as I said recently, I've cut out dairy, which has helped actually help the sinus problem quite significantly. And I'm not someone who's ever been prone to allergies before, and yet suddenly my body is in screaming allergic reaction mode. It seems to react to anything it's getting the opportunity to react to, you know, and it's very bizarre. It feels like I am inhabiting a body that isn't mine, or that I'm not familiar with, which is very peculiar. So, anyway, the poetry collaboration and competition, I will be getting that up tomorrow. There are going to be several videos because I had lots of entries and my connection is so incredibly slow that was the only way I could put them up, but I'll link them all. And it's great. It's really great. It's so varied. It's fantastic. So if you do have one to get to me, then please get it to me before bedtime, my bedtime tonight, which will depend on where you are in the world, of course. But, you know, before midnight-ish tonight, please, if you can manage it. Otherwise, it's not going to end up as part of it. So I'm in a bit of a mess at the moment. Hopefully I will get on top of it, but it feels quite depressing, actually.